right, everybody, we're going to get started here in just a moment. We know we have buses clearing out, so just give us one more minute and we'll get started. I know everybody's nervous and excited, so we'll get started. Just give me one or two more minutes and we'll get this ceremony going. Thank you. Not used to being on stage. It's not used to it. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Matthew Helms, and I am one of the coordinators for NHD International. And the title of my presentation today is the NHD International Contest Award Ceremony for 2023. May I begin? Thank you. I love having permission to take the stage. And with that, I would like to have you listen to just a brief message from my other coordinator as she gives you a warm welcome as well. Off we go.
Hi, everyone. My name is Hilary Samuels, and I am one of the co-coordinators of NHD International. Unfortunately, I can't be there with you in person, so I'm recording this video so I can still speak to you and celebrate all of your accomplishments and achievements with NHD this year. This has been the first year of NHD International as opposed to the previous NHD South Asia, and it has been a huge success so far. We have had an enormous 164 projects submitted with 252 students involved and 63 different teams. This has been fantastic, and it's been so exciting to see all of the different ideas that you've come up with from all of your different locations. We have had projects submitted from Thailand, Singapore, Japan, China, Vietnam, Indonesia, and even South Africa. I've been so impressed to see the different ways that you've interpreted the theme of frontiers in history and all the different range of ideas that we have been able to read. As judges, it has genuinely been really interesting and exciting to come through and look at all of your different projects. You should be so very proud of yourselves. The topics have ranged enormously from pioneers in the Mormons, ancient Egypt, Japanese jazz, rats in Cambodia, Martin Luther, aviation history, and Edward Jenner. It has been absolutely fantastic. I wish you the best of luck with the award ceremony, and I look forward to seeing lots of you progress to the next stage. Well done, and I'll hand over to Mr. Elms from here. Thank you.
Thank you, Hillary.
Hi, everyone.
It happens all the time to teachers. So, yes, we are NHD International for 2023, and we've been working kind of on a slogan, and this is what we come, fortunately, I don't know if anybody's watched the award shows lately, but we came up with everyone from everywhere all at once. And I feel that's really how we are, because if we go to the next slide, what you'll see is that we are from 44 different international schools from around the world. Now, I'm not going to read every one of those one by one, but what I am going to do is ask my students who are here today, what you need to do is quickly count how many different countries are in our program. Now, Hong Kong will come up again, and it will be one of those countries. We'll count them as a separate country. If you get the answer right, if you get it right, I will give you a Kit Kat candy bar when you come back. Now, if you're wrong, you give me one. Thank you. Next slide, please. keep counting. I need hands. Here we go. Hands up. Go, Jenny. Wrong. You owe me a candy bar. Wrong. Owe me a candy bar. Wrong. Owe me a candy bar. It is 14. Yeah, well done. Thank you, Shreya. I look forward to those candy bars tomorrow on my desk. Thank you very much. Now, I also want to take a moment and just recognize all the different judges from around the world who have been participating in the judging over the last 2 weeks. We have 51 NHT international judges for this year, and you can see all the different names up there, and I'm sure those of you who are watching from around the world will recognize different teachers, different administrators. We had volunteers all the way from Florida. We had volunteers from Texas, Alabama, Pennsylvania, literally around the world as we were trying to do the heavy lifting with this contest. We had judges who were reading 15 to 18 different papers for the senior division as they were plowing through to try to find which were the best projects that they wanted to push forward to the next round. We can go to the next slide as well, and you will see even more names, people from the Dominican Republic. And it's an incredible experience to be a judge, and as a judge myself, it's one of the best professional development experiences that you've ever gone through. It's nerve-wracking, it's stressful. We write comments for every single project and trying to give insightful thoughts for each student as they work through the contest. Now, this is a good moment to mention real quickly that in some categories, we had 8 to 10 projects. So in those cases, generally speaking, we just did one round of judging, which would have meant that we would have, for example, one group of 10. But if we had too many students, for example, in the senior paper division, we had almost 50 papers. So what we do is we do preliminary rounds, we select the top two projects, and then we push them forward to the final rounds. That's gonna be important later when you're starting to look at evaluations. If you have two different types of evaluations, it means your project went from the preliminary round to the final round, and that's a good thing. So we will get back to the contest more in just a moment. But I think I want to bring up to somebody on stage. There's not a lot of people who have as much experience as myself and my other co-presenter, Ms. Jennifer Katulski. But I do have a student with me who's been doing NHD now for 6 years. You've been working with NHD starting in 7th grade. She is now a senior at Singapore American School, getting ready to graduate. And I want to bring up to the stage the amazing Jessica Kim. Come on up, Jessica.
Thank you, Mr. Elms, and good afternoon, everyone. Like you said, my name is Jessica Kim, and I'm a senior here at Singapore American School, and I'm also an alumna of National History Day. I participated in 7th and 8th grade, and then have volunteered over the years with the competition. And as a senior, I've been doing a lot of reflecting over the past year, first for my college application essays in the fall, but also more recently as I prepare to leave the school that's been my home for the past 12 years. And after all this reflection, I can confidently tell you all that NHD was one of the perhaps one of the most influential and important experiences I've had in my life so far. Now, that's going to probably sound very dramatic to a lot of you, but honestly, it's the truth. Let me step back and set the scene for you all a bit. When I participated in NHD as a 7th grader, I built a website on ping pong diplomacy, and my NHD journey ended here in South Asia, which is now NHD International. My little 7th grade heart was crushed. I didn't know how to deal with the idea that I'd put so much time and effort into something and it had simply just not been good enough. But I came back in 8th grade with a team and something to prove. We chose to study the clandestine or secret art therapy lessons that took place in the Terezin Ghetto during the Holocaust. And over the year, like many of you, we spent nearly every afternoon in our teacher's classroom revising our captions, building our exhibit board, and writing annotations for our bibliographies. And I visited the Terezin Ghetto in the Czech Republic over winter break and interviewed Holocaust survivors, historians, and museum curators. Between our group members, it was a lot of hours that were put in to make the project the best it could be. We were elated and over the moon when we won first place in the South Asia affiliate competition. But we got back to work almost immediately, and by the time we got to nationals, we were so excited to share the stories of the children from the Terezin Ghetto. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough. We didn't place in the top 10, though we did earn an honorable mention placing us in the top 20. But it really wasn't the result we were hoping for. But I'll get to the point, though. There were so many lessons that I learned from NHD despite us not winning. And because it taught me about the power of persistence, how to deal with rejection, collaborating in high-stress situations, how to receive feedback without taking it personally, when to lead and when to take a step back, the value of gratitude, and the importance of reflection. But perhaps most importantly, NHD taught me just how critical a historian's job is. When we were in NHD, we sometimes talked about something called the burden of storytelling. Some of you might have heard Mr. Elms talk about this. And it's the idea that as historians, we have a responsibility to accurately tell and share the stories of those that we study. We aren't meant to just learn about interesting things that happened in the past. We're meant to share them with other people in an engaging, yet unbiased and accurate way. But as an eighth grader, I never really thought the concept was super applicable to me because I always thought, well, who doesn't know about the Holocaust? Plus, it was a really depressing topic to talk about, and no one really none of my friends really wanted to hear about it at lunch or after school. But sometime when I was in 10th grade, I was sitting in advisory, and we were commemorating Holocaust Remembrance Day. And next to me, a girl tentatively raised her hand and said, "What's the Holocaust?" I was shocked. How could someone not know what the Holocaust was? So the first thing I did was run to lunch, and I ranted to my friends for half an hour about how ignorant it was that this girl had no idea what the Holocaust was. On behalf of all the children that I'd spent a year learning about, I found it deeply offensive that someone in 10th grade wouldn't know what the Holocaust was. But upon reflection, I realized that actually the girl hadn't really done anything wrong. It was more of a failure of the school system that she had been in that she'd never heard of the Holocaust. And more specifically, I realized that at SAS, there was no standardized time between kindergarten and 12th grade where a student would learn about genocide or the Holocaust as mandated by the curriculum. Instead, it was up to individual teachers whether it would be taught. Around the same time, I started thinking about how I could pursue my Girl Scout Gold Award, which challenges older Girl Scouts to create and make a sustainable change in their community and around the world. So throughout my junior year, with the help of educators from elementary, middle, and high school at SAS, I created lessons for 600 fourth and fifth graders to learn about the Holocaust and the implications of anti-Semitism. As I worked with SAS teachers, Holocaust Center directors, and leaders of the local United Hebrew congregation, I developed and taught lessons that aligned with fourth and fifth grade social studies standards. The same year, I took the opportunity in AP Research, an inquiry and project-based course very similar to NHD that you should all take in 11th and 12th grade, more deeply learn about the clandestine or secret education of students in the Terezin Ghetto. And I say all these things not to make you think that now that you've done NHD or done a project, you are tied to your topic forever and you are solely responsible for telling that particular story forever and ever, but more broadly, that as a historian, you are responsible for telling stories. And whether you progress to nationals or not in the next half hour, your job as a historian is not done. Take the broad life lessons from what you've learned, the reflection, gratitude, collaboration, leadership, research, writing, and much more, but also take with you this call to continue sharing stories from the past, whether that's in large-scale formalized ways or even informally with your friends and community members. Because in terms of sharing history with other people, I mean, why do we do that? I think a lot of times people will say things like, history repeats itself, and so it's important for us to understand. But ultimately, that's kind of a simplification, because history doesn't repeat itself, rather, it rhymes. We need to recognize that everything that happens in the present isn't particularly novel or new, but rather a slight play on something that's happened in the past. And only by understanding the past can we fully appreciate and respond to the present. So continue doing the great work that you've started and began this year. Continue asking great questions and continue seeking to share your learning with others. Thank you, and I wish you all the best of luck in this year's competition.
All right, thank you, Jessica. It's obvious why she was selected to do this. She's amazing. I also like to clarify for everybody that we have fixed the error of not having the Holocaust in our curriculum. That is now in our curriculum for those of you here at SAS and around the world. Thanks, Jessica. Next. So let's get into some contest information, and then we'll get to the award ceremony. Next. First of all, judges' evaluations will be available later today on the NHD International Registration website. The decisions of the judges are final. We do not go back and change something unless there's an issue of plagiarism, cheating, or something of those sorts. Medals will be mailed to the schools for first and second place finalists once payment has been received. Certificates as well will be mailed to the schools by email. Again, those are going to be sent once payment has been confirmed. First and second place finalists are invited to attend the NHD National Finals in June of 2023 at the University of Maryland. The next steps for the NHD finalists will be presented at the end of this presentation to qualifiers. I will also send that out on email, so please, finalists, hang around for just a few minutes so we can go over some details with you. Next, third place finishers are alternates in case the first or second place declines the invitation to go to nationals. These students will be notified by Mr. Elms by Friday, March 24th, of their status. No, we don't keep moving people up from fourth place, fifth place, sixth place. No, we stop at third. And now we will begin announcing the third place finishers, second place finishers, first place finishers, and then we will also honor the honorable mention projects in each of 18 categories. And with that, I'd like to bring to the stage my colleague for many years, I think 18 years we've been working together, Ms. Jennifer Katulski, to start with the junior division papers.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Jennifer Koltowski, and I've had the pleasure of working with Matthew Elms with the NHD program at SAS. And it is my honor and pleasure to represent the awards for the junior division category for this year's NHD contest. So we'll start with junior division historical paper. Are you ready? Here we go. All right, in third place, from Chiang Mai International School. The title of the project is The Nutrition Labeling and Education Act of 1990, Crossing the Frontier of Legal Action Against Obesity and Other Forms of Malnutrition in the USA, by Chloe Caguin. In second place, and the first qualifying project for nationals, from Singapore American School. The title of the project is U.S. Recognition of India, a New Diplomatic Frontier Promoting Democracy, Global Stability and Economic Advancement, Veer Bajaj. Congratulations. And in first place, from Singapore American School. The title of the project is The International Sweethearts of Rhythm, a frontier created by the first interracial all-women swing band, by Sienna Abraham. Congratulations. And we have an honorable mention for a project from Chiang Mai International School. The title of the project is The Internal Combustion Engine, Noah Hatton.
All right. Now, we will be doing the senior division historical papers. Once again, we had about 50 papers submitted. So what we did in this category is we selected the top two in the preliminary, which gave us 10 papers in the final round. So I'll be going through third place, second place, first place, and then I will also announce all of those student projects because they deserve recognition as honorable mentions. So on we go. Here we go. In third place, from Shanghai SMIC Private School in China, the title of the project, Sovereignty, Suffering, and Censorship, The Changing Meaning of the Great Wall of China, by Siyi Din. In second place, from Saisen International School in Japan, Frontiers in History, When Joseph Stalin's Collectivization Scheme in the USSR, A Novel Frontier, by Dan Yu Oh. And in first place from Shanghai SMIC Private School in China, When Beats Break Oppression, Rock Music in the Soviet Union Fights for Freedom of Expression, from Christy Kang. Congratulations. All right, if we could get onto the next slide, you can see all of these different historical papers. I'm just gonna go through them real quickly. From Concordia International School in Hanoi, Vietnam, Crime and Technology, Interpol as a pioneer in international criminal investigation, Yoo Hyun Kim, and we'll just hold applause till the end. United World College in Changzhou, China, Alan Locke, Establishing a New Frontier for African Americans in the Harlem Renaissance, by Shoshun Chuang. From White Oak Secondary School in Canada. Yes, Canada shows up. Yeah, go Canadians. The success and failure of James A. Houston's Sunyusuk Eskimo Handicrafts on Contemporary Inuit Fine Art, by Isabel Wang. From QSI International School in Sichuan, China, The Union Colony of Colorado, Go West, Young Man, from Kevin Shin. The Experimental High School Attached to Beijing Normal University, Redefining the Frontiers of Women and Gender, Simon de Bolivar, and the Second Wave Feminism, from Hong Yu Hu. From Shenzhen College of International Education in China, RICO, Judicial Frontiers in Combating the American Mafia, from QU Liao. And from American International School of Chennai, India, Hangul, the Great Frontier of Written Language that Innovated Communication in Joseon, the Old Korea, from Ji Yun Yang. Congratulations to all of them.
All right, moving along to the category of individual documentary. Many, many hours of work go into a documentary. Don't believe me? Try and make one. All right, in third place, from Chiang Mai International School, Thailand, the title is From Sputnik to Space Race, Crossing the Ultimate Frontier, by Liam Stinchcomb. And our first qualifying project for nationals in this category, in second place, from Singapore American School, the title is The Papunya Tula Art Movement, A Captivating Artistic Frontier in Indigenous Australian Dreamings, by Maya Lim Laurie. Congratulations. And in first place, from Singapore American School, Combating Racial Discrimination Barriers, Athia Gibson Crosses the Color Frontier, by Aditya Chakravarti. Congratulations. I think she's happy. And we do have an honorable mention for this category from Chiang Mai International School, Thailand, The First Radio, Guglielmo Marconi, by John Barry.
All right, in the senior division, individual documentary, in third place, from the American International School of Chennai in India, Space Race, The Rivalry Between the USSR and the USA, by Vidya Sinha Pinkar. In second place, and also qualifying for the national contest, and also from Chiang Mai International School in Thailand, the title is Battleship Potemkin, A New Frontier for Filmmaking, by Mohan Yu. In first place, from the American International School of Chennai in India, How Long? Not Long, The March on Selma, from Rosalie Johnson. And we have an honorable mention in this category from the International School of Altdorf, Switzerland, The Fall of the Poland People's Republic, The Shift of the Frontiers Between East and the West, from Zhengxin Huang. Congratulations to all of you.
Okay, back to junior division. The category is group documentary. In third place, from Singapore American School, Ellie Wiesel, Advancing the Frontier Against Racism and Hatred by Jay Agnaharty and Orson Stewart. In second place, from Chiang Mai International School, Thailand, The Great Revolution, The Wheat of Hope in India, by Hashi Laksanapirak and Weewish Mahawang. And in first place, from Singapore American School, Unveiling the Plight of the South African Rhinoceros, Creating Frontiers Through Challenges and Innovation, Taryn Rim and Kayla Chiao. Congratulations. And an honorable mention goes to British School of Jakarta, Indonesia. Murder for a Penny, How Jack the Ripper Crossed a Frontier in Entertainment, Rachel Luckman and Vin Weiler.
Can I just see the next slide real quick, please? Okay, I see what you did. Thanks. All right. I just want to make sure I'm in the right one. Senior Division Group Documentary. Okay, Senior Division Group Documentary. In third place, it's a little odd, sorry. In third place, from Shanghai SMIC Private School in China, Japanese Jazz, from Xinjiang Chao and Daniel Yeo. In second place, from Shanghai SMIC Private School in China, Hollywood, Frontier of Racial Perspectives, from Tingying Chun and Brendan Lin. And finally, in first place and qualifying for the national contest, from QSI International School in Shenzhen, China, Exploring the Frontiers of Dream and Reality, The Traversal of Homesteaders into the Wild West, by Stephen Chen, Dongwon Max Kim, and Angel Wu, David Zhu, and Tukuk Yadav. Thank you. And again, in this category, we do have an honorable mention from the American International School of Chennai in India. That's the title is Fritz Haber, Benefactor or Criminal, Victor Gomez Kanat and Sang Woon Park. Congratulations, all of you.
All right, moving along to the category of individual website, junior division. In third place, from Chiang Mai International School, Thailand, Chinese Immigration, The Struggle for a New Frontier in the U.S., by Paul Wewita Wanga Wana. In second place, in qualifying for a spot at Nationals, from Singapore American School, Apopo Rats, A New Frontier in Explosive Detection by Daniel Yang. I think it was a year ago you went to meet those rats, right, Mr. Holmes? Okay. And in first place from Singapore American School, A Case for Loving, A Frontier for Interracial Marriage by Adia Narayana. Congratulations. And we do have an honorable mention for Chiang Mai International School, Thailand, Organ Transplantation by Pasawat Chenyasak.
In the senior division, individual websites, here we go. In third place, from Shanghai SMIC Private School in China, their title is The Fight for Equality, Brown versus the Board of Education of Topeka Challenges School Segregation in the U.S., from Joy Wei. In second place, from the American International School of Chennai, India. And the title is, and I love this project, Women's Pockets et la Révolutionnaire Française, from Archista Sarath. In first place, from Shanghai, SMIC Private School in China, Rachel Carson's Silent Spring, Establishing a Frontier in Environmentalism, from Ehun Yra. And finally, our honorable mention in this category, from the American International School of Chennai, India, the work behind the scenes, Women in World War II, from Madeline Ann Coggan. Thank you very much.
All right, now it's back to junior division in the category of group website. A real test for collaboration skills. In third place, from Singapore American School, The Nightingale of India, A Frontier for Indian Women, Shreya Kachar and Jaya Nath. In second place, qualifying for nationals, from Chiang Mai International School, Thailand, George Washington Carver, A Frontier in Agricultural History, Gary Huang and Kimmy Sun. Congratulations. And in first place, from Singapore American School, LA Riots of 1992, How Restorative Justice Uplifted Society, Jenny Jiang and Sebin Kim. Congratulations. And an honorable mention goes to Chiang Mai International School in Thailand. The First Industrial Revolution, A Great Leap Forward for Mankind. Adam Chu and Tian Duan Zhu.
To mention my official medal giver outer, her name is Jacqueline Lee. She was one of Jessica's Kim partners, so give her a big round of applause for helping out. Yeah, I get too nervous to do everything, so I really need a lot of support systems to help me get through these difficult moments. Here we go. In the category of senior division group website, in third place, from QSI International School in Shenzhen, China, the Proclamation of 1763, Breaking the American Frontiers, by Zhou Bianho and Jerry Wang. In second place, from Concordia International School in Hanoi, Vietnam, the first year that they have participated, Dorothea Dix, Crossing the Social Frontier of Mental Health, from Yui Izazaki, Hyun Sun Yu Jung, Jae Eun Ko, oh my gosh, Go Myung Jin Lee, and Kwang Ang Pam. I know, it's rough. And in first place, from QSI International School in Shenzhen, China, I've been working on the railroad, Chinese immigrants on the American frontier, from Maya Lily Dunn and Cheng Ting Zhong. Congratulations to those three. We do have an honorable mention here from the American International School of Chennai, India, Globalization of Semiconductor, from Sehun Bei and Chengguan Zhou and Yong Wu Son. Congratulations to all of you.
All right, back to the junior division with what I consider to be one of the hardest categories. Imagine doing a 10-minute performance, performing all the characters by yourself. This is individual performance. In second place, from Singapore American School, Josephine Baker, Fame to Hide a Secret Frontier, Sophie White. She's off to nationals to perform it live for a new audience. And in first place, joining her with an invitation to nationals from Singapore American School, the Pecora Commission, A Revolutionary Frontier in Finance, Rihanna Fisher.
All right. And in the senior division, individual performance, we have one project that was selected by the judges to move forward to the national round. And the title of that, I'm sorry, the school in first place is Shattuck St. Mary Forest City, an international school, Malaysia. The title of their project was Mormon Pioneers Journey to Utah. And our student is Naomi Tanner. Congratulations to Naomi. And for all of you fine students out there, if you're looking to get to nationals, performance is the way to go.
All right, moving on to group performances in the junior division category. We have a really great project that's been invited to go to nationals from Singapore American School. The Rosenwald Schools, Creating New Frontiers in African-American Education in the Jim Crow South. Sophie DeWan and Leah McDonnell. Congratulations.
In the senior division group performances, we have just one honorable mention project, and this honorable mention project comes to us from Shanghai United International School of the Wangyu campus in China. The title of their project, The French Revolution, Frontiers in History by Peter Lee and Betty Zhu. The judges wanted to recognize them for their outstanding energy and creativity in the project and the performance of their project, and congratulations to those two. Give them a big round of applause.
All right, back to junior division, this time individual exhibits. In third place, from Singapore American School, The Battle of Tarawa, the title of The Tide of Things to Come by James Nagel. And in second place, invited to nationals from Singapore American School. I love this title. All American Girls Professional Baseball League, A New Frontier for Women to Kick Grass by Greta Booth. That's great. Also from Singapore American School in first place, The Disc Record, A Revolution in Sound by Grace Jung. Congratulations. Honorable mention goes to Chiang Mai International School, Thailand. Kate Shepherd, The Woman Who Created a New Democratic Frontier by Cora Freeman.
In the senior division of individual exhibits, in third place from the American International School of Chennai, India, Reconstruction of Japan by Ari Otani. In second place from the American International School of India again and qualifying for the national finals, The Desperate Decision Made During the End of World War II, Atomic Bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki by Yoo-Sun Kim. In first place from Chiang Mai International School of Thailand, Da Vinci, Forging a Path to the Future by Yina Yao. And we do have an honorable mention here from the American International School of Chennai, India, The Wright Brothers, First Air Machine by Yasmin Mukhtar. I think we just have one category left. Maybe we should just go home now. Those poor junior group exhibit kids.
Jackie, are you having flashbacks? This was her category. It's a nail biter. All right, group exhibits. Here we go. In third place, from Singapore American School. The title of their project is The Survivors of Hiroshima, Rebuilding Life Within a Nuclear Frontier, by Cole Agarwal and Aditi Razdan. In second place, in qualifying for nationals from Chiang Mai International School, Thailand, Margaret Sanger, Overturning Fundamental Frontiers in Women's Reproductive History, by Songbo Su and Nana Temtamarok. And in first place, from Singapore American School, Friedel Dickerbrandes, Creating Emotional Support in Terezin, by Yenna Cho and Claire Lee. Congratulations. And honorable mention goes to a project from Singapore American School titled Japanese Picture Brides, Creating Economic and Social Frontiers in America, Arum Chen and Claire Kim.
Very much. All right, in our final category of senior group exhibits, here we go. In third place, from Sekolah Pelita Harapan Pelud Village in Indonesia, Uniform Education from Dewey Sartika Pioneer Frontier by Valerie Joko Wijaja, Quentin Huftel, Nadine Pandopatan, and Chloe Tegu. Thank you, that was third place. In second place, from the American International School of Chennai, India, we have one of my favorite titles, The Three-Point Seatbelt, The Messiah of Road Traffic Accidents. Yes, from Chang Woo Kim and So Yeon Kim. Congratulations. And I have to say, the senior division really brought some great titles. Here we go, in first place, from Sekolah Pelita Harapan Pelud Village in Indonesia, Frontiers in Punk Rock, Riot Girl, yeah! From Annabelle Bethwet Huang, Sophie Q, Zisela Nicole Lim, and Chisnini Sejuti. And our honorable mention from QSI, sorry, let's give them a round of applause, in first place, from QSI International School in Shenzhen, China, The People, The Dream, The Frontier, from Fa Seng Pei, Kion Pyo, and Si Kai Wang. Congratulations to all of you. So just before we move on, I'm going to just tell a brief story. This is sort of my grandpa's story from being in NHD since 1995. The first time I ever took a group to nationals, it took me, I want to say as a teacher, 8 years to get to that level. It was two lovely students, sixth graders. They'd worked forever on a project about Galileo. They had amazing sources. They did interviews. They did everything they could. They made it to the national competition. And they sat in an award ceremony much like this, but only with 10 to 15,000 people. And they heard the announcements made, and they didn't win. They didn't make finals. And so then we had to make our way from the award ceremony to the airport, and my two young ladies were just buckets of tears, just so upset, hurt, sad, crushed. And so as a teacher, I was trying to kind of bolster them up, give them that pep talk. I got on the plane and sat down. A gentleman next to me said, "Hey, are you a teacher?" And I said, "Yeah, I'm a teacher." And he goes, those your kids crying over there?" I looked over, "Yeah." And those are mine. He goes, "Congratulations, teachers. That teacher, that's a great job you've done." And I'm like, I've crushed my kids, sir. I don't know what you mean." He says, "That's the best tears of all. As a teacher, you have gotten these kids to invest in something that's really critical, really vital to them, and very important to them. And they're grieving now. So let them grieve. Let them learn from their process. Let them learn from the pain. At times it's hard, and I do recognize the pain that my students are feeling sometimes right now. I also understand the joy that some of my students are feeling. And so there's a lot of mixed emotions in this room right now, and I'm sure wherever you're watching those videos. And so with that being said, if we could go to the next slide. In a few hours, Mr. Holmes, that's me, I will turn on a feature that allows students to review their evaluations online. So when that happens, and only when that happens, step one, log into your international NHC account with your username and login credentials. Step two, click on your name in the top right-hand corner and go to your profile. Step three, along the left edge, you will now notice a new tab called eval. This is where your evaluation should be located. In the preliminary round of judging, there are rubrics, rules compliance, and comments from the multiple judges who looked at your projects. In the final round of judging, there are only comments from the head judge. Not all categories have final rounds, so if you have questions, you can ask me at a later time. We only conduct final rounds of judging if there are too many entries in a category to complete the rankings in one preliminary round. Now, if for some unknown reason you cannot locate your evaluation, you should ask your parents for help. If you still can't find the system to work, then ask your teacher for help. If you still can't get the system to show you the right evaluations, ask your tech-savvy friends. Then, and only then, and after deep philosophical conversations and thoughts with yourself, if you still can't find your evaluations, you can write to me, Mr. Elms, at melms@sas.edu. I will reply to you as soon as possible. And if we could just go to the next slide, please, just a few last announcements. Here we go. The National History Day theme for 2024 will be Turning Points in History. The NHD 2024 NHD International Contest will be a hybrid event, which I'm inventing in my mind right now, a virtual in-person contest, and that will be hosted at, yes, Shattuck St. Mary's Forest City International School in Johor, Malaysia, March 15th through the 17th next year in 2024. And I want to thank all of you for coming. I will be out in front as soon as I can because I know people will want to talk to me, but I need to have all finalists please stay here and talk to me. So that's anybody who is first or second who's in the room. And so everyone else, you can head outside. Thank you very much for coming. Congratulations to one and all. Thank you. Hello, great. If you are a national finalist, students, I need you right here, right in front of me, right now. Thank you. So that is everybody who is first or second place. If you are third place and you just want to listen in, you're welcome to listen. But this is for first and second place. I like to get started because I know people are trying to get to buses and they got a lot going on. Let's go first or second place. Here we go. I want to get to this so you can get some more information because I know your parents need it. Daniel Yang, come on down. Parents, you're welcome to stay. It's fine. Yeah, I think the video is still running up there, Sharon, yeah? Yeah, Sharon says it's still running. Okay, here we go. So, I just need to go through a few things right now. Thank you. So I know some of the third place people are staying here and that's fine. So I need to tell you some of the things you need to do next. All right, Sharon, if you could go to the next slide, please. So the first thing, and this is more important than anything else, you must be humble in defeat and gracious in victory. And what I mean by that is you must be, your attitude right now matters. It matters to your friends, it matters to your parents. You can celebrate, but just remember that that celebration might be taken the wrong way. So that includes in person and online. So if people want to congratulate you, certainly accept their congratulations and then share the love with everybody who's supported you through this process. Next, on the next slide, and if you want to have a phone out right now, you can have a phone out, but I will also send this QR code out to everybody. Will be more information about how to you get to the next level. So this QR code is to confirm your spot for nationals. It's required for all first and second place students. Finalists, including every single member of a group, have to do this, okay? You must individually confirm your invitation to nationals by Friday, March 24, 2023. That is a week from tomorrow on the Google form. Don't be a fool, use the Google form. Otherwise, I will need to give your spot away to the third place, because if you are a third place finisher, you need answers and you need them now, and so do the parents. So national finalists, first and second place, you get the right of first refusal. If you don't exercise due diligence, then I will exercise it for you, and I don't want to do that. Next, the official registration for NHC Nationals will begin in April. So we got a little bit of breathing time, and it's gonna be time for you to think. Please keep an eye on your email at nhc.org for more details. Awards, medals, and certificates for the NHC International will only be sent to those students and schools who have completed payment for the international contest. Students that have not paid will, of course, be permitted you can't register for the national event if you haven't paid for this. SAS parents, you're paid for. We already paid, so not you, okay? We are finalizing the national t-shirt design and button designs. We'll keep everybody up to date. So every affiliate around the world and throughout the US has different t-shirt designs, buttons that we trade, and we're working on those. All of you will get t-shirts to wear at the national event. Next slide. There we go. So there's your QR code. So this is for the first and second place people. I know parents are looking at that box on the left, and the particular thing you really want to know is, when is Nationals? It's an in-person only event. So that is Sunday, June 11th to the 15th, 2023 at the University of Maryland at College Park. Now, we've had lots of conversations at the national level with myself for International NHD. It is an in-person contest. They are not running a virtual contest. So unfortunately, if you're not able to attend, then you are gonna need to withdraw your name. And that is, of course, unfortunate. But we decided to run the contest and run it as honorable as we could, even given the current constraints. And at the time, we were operating with the hope that COVID would move on and that we could have this event. This will be the first time that we've had a national event in 4 years. So Jessica's team was the last team who went to nationals from SAS during that year. Hers and other teams, but that was the last year who actually went. Okay, so. I think that's the last slide, Sharon. Can you just, so if you have any questions and you want to email me, you can. Of course, more communication will be coming out. I will post results online, emails will be coming out, so we can do that. I will take two questions that people are dying to know, and then we're gonna wrap this up and send people on the way. Do I have any questions? Go. Great, so can you just, Sharon, can you go back one slide? There's a lot of details here. That date of the 11th is registration day. So I can go into a lot more detail and I will do so later. So the question was, what day, what is happening on which day? So your question is, on the 11th is registration. On the Monday, starting at 8 a.m. is junior division, judging for all categories. You have to be there. So that's the Monday. So I usually get there like Friday or Saturday, get myself sort of sorted out on Washington DC time, get to the university. I usually stay at the dorms. We will send out information regarding housing and dorms. Some people like dorms, I don't. I stay in them anyway because I don't want to deal with the commute. There are hotels, we'll send out more information later. So back to the story. Sunday is registration, Monday, all junior division. Tuesday is senior division. And listen carefully, if and only if you are a performer or a documentary, do you get invited back for a second time of judging on Tuesday night. But you have to be one of the top 10 in the nation at that point. I can go into more details on that later, but you may have to come back, performers and documentary people. There are no callbacks for papers, websites, and exhibits. One more question. awesome. That means I've done everything right. Have a great evening, everybody. Thank you very much.